O'Connor, Commander Burke, Commander Curcio, Chairs of the Sea, Land, Air, and Cadet of Nova Scotia, Major Riddle, Cadet Coast Guard and Staff, Honored Guests, Assembled Cadets, Ladies and Gentlemen. My name is Captain Heather Constantine. I will be your guest officer for today's event. Welcome to this ceremony celebrating the 4th Annual Cadet Day in Nova Scotia. Bill number 23, designated the first Saturday in October of each year as Sea, Army, Air, and Navy League Cadet Day in Nova Scotia, was introduced in the legislature by Premier Dexter on April 12, 2010. It received royal assent on May 11, 2010, and the first Cadet Day was marked across the province in 2010. The Act to establish the day to recognize the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadet, and the Navy Cadets in Nova Scotia is a fitting testimony to the lengthy history of service that thousands of young Nova Scotians have provided in the many communities across the province as members of the Canadian Cadet Organization. We gather today to pay tribute to the Cadets in Nova Scotia and to formally celebrate Cadet Day. I shall officially begin today's program by reading the Act. An Act to establish a day to recognize the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets and Navy League Cadets of Nova Scotia. Whereas the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets and Navy League Cadets have a lengthy history of service in Nova Scotia, and whereas the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets and the Navy League Cadets are a positive influence in today's society, and whereas the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, Air Cadets, and Navy League Cadets provide young people with positive opportunities to develop self-confidence, self-esteem, self-discipline, and respect for others, and whereas the young people involved in the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets, and Navy League Cadets learn valuable life and work skills, such as teamwork, leadership, good citizenship, and physical fitness that will benefit them no matter what path they choose. And whereas the young people involved in the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets and the Navy League Cadets are rewarded with a sense of accomplishment, recognition from their peers and mentors, once-in-a-lifetime personal and professional growth experiences, lifelong friends, and a chance to show their talents and their maturity. Whereas the hard work and dedication of all those involved in the Royal Canadian Sea, Army, and Air Cadets and the Navy League Cadets should be recognized. Therefore, be it enacted by the Governor and Assembly as follows. This Act may be cited as the Sea, Army, Air, and Navy League Cadets Day Act. And throughout the province, each and every year, the first Saturday in October shall be kept and observed under the name of Sea, Army, Air, and Navy League Cadet Day. In our speaking parts this morning, I can now call upon Mr. Earl Korn, President of the Mainline Division of the Nova Scotia Navy League of Canada, to bring remarks on behalf of the Sea, Army, and Air Cadet Leagues.
Hooray! Then at ease! And easy!
Your Honor, cadets, parents, friends, whoever's listening, this is a phenomenal day. They don't get any better than this. Because standing in front of us all right now are the future of the greatest nation in the world. These are our children who are phenomenal. This program brings them, as Captain Constantine has indicated, a step forward to the best thing that will ever happen to them in their life. You can talk to any Mountie or city police officer, you're not going to find any of these kids' names on any of them badges. These are tremendous, tremendous young men and women. To take it one step further, I guess what's really important is that the government recognize how important this is and gave them their day. So we want to thank the government for doing that. And I guess we wish them all luck because there's nobody here today, wherever they're doing. But if they would have been smart, I think they would have been here today because This is the future, and this is where they should have been. Looking at these young men and women, I'm so, so proud of you. So on behalf of the Navy League, the Air League, and the Army League, I want you to have more than a phenomenal day, because you're all outstanding. As I always say to you, look in the mirror when you get home today, smile, for you should be very proud of who you see. Thank you.